what is channel bagging and why you should use it. In this video, I'm going to show you how to bag your textures using Photoshop. Then, we are going to set up correctly in Unreal Engine. But first, let me explain what channel bagging is and why it is important. So, let's get started. Channel bagging means taking different grayscale images and bagging each one into individual channels of a texture map. Red, green, blue, and alpha channel, which is optional. Channel bagging helps us to avoid reaching the maximum capacity of texture samplers that can be used in a single material. For instance, if we use three separated grayscale images, we are adding three texture samplers. If we use one packed texture map, we are adding only one texture sampler to the total amount. In addition, if you want to use more than 16 texture samplers, you can set the sampler source from texture asset to shared wrap. As you can see, using less texture images will save memory in our video card, which is also great for optimizing our projects. There are many types of packed textures, and the position of each grayscale image depends on what kind of asset you are going to use. In this case, we are going to create a roughness, metallic, and ambient occlusion mask. Before we start, I just to point out that this process can be created in programs like GIMP, Substance Painter, or Substance Designer. For this example, I'm going to show you how to create it in Photoshop. So let's jump into it. So, we are creating a new file in 2K resolution size. I have already imported my maps. This is the roughness map, the metallic map, and the ambient occlusion map. Let's go to channels. In the red one, we are going to copy paste the roughness map by selecting all, Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Repeat the same process with the metallic and the ambient occlusion map. Now we have three maps in each individual channel, which is our packed texture. To save this, we can use a PNG format, but we are going to save it as a target file. If you have created an alpha channel, you must choose the last one option. If not, we are okay with the second one. And that's it. Let's import a texture. Double click to open this window. In the compression settings, choose masks, then save it. Finally, let's plug each RGB channel into the correct input. Make sure to save it. And there you have it. So, if you found this helpful, then please like and subscribe. I'm going to share more videos related to game dev. And also you can get free resources in the link below. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and see you next time.